Just to illustrate how the heat sinks work, and we are using ceramic tiles with polystyrene glued to the back. We have the probe right there from the thermometer, which sits there, and that would be able to measure the temperature. Now, I'm going to simulate the sun with a halogen lamp. It's a work light, a double light, and I'm going to just show you how the test's being done inside a building or in a classroom. So we could very simply pop those down and leave it for a while. I'm just holding it for now, but we can use it on the stand, and that would heat up the tiles. Now, I can leave that for a couple of minutes, or I could take these tiles and put them outside and get students to bring them in. We can already see right there how the temperature changes. It was 19.4, it's already 20.6. So as I leave this, it would absorb the heat or the energy from the halogen lamps. And once I take this away, it would release the energy which it absorbed and stored in the thermal mass, and during winter would be able to release this slowly. So these tiles fits inside the building. So the sun which sits over here somewhere would shine into the building and heat it up. The ideal would be to have this in concrete, brick, or any other similar material which absorbs a lot of heat. So you want, in passive solar design, you want the walls made of concrete brick or concrete blocks. That's the ideal. I have a concrete block here and a ceramic tile with some polystyrene glued to the back. Now, if I leave this concrete block in the sun, as well as the ceramic tile, the sun would heat it up and it would absorb the energy and release it slowly. So if I leave it out in the sun for about an hour, and when I bring it into the building, for instance, and I touch it, it would be warm. I have a thermometer here. The top reading is the exterior reading, and the bottom one's interior. Interior meaning that's the ambient temperature in the room right now. This is a probe which is connected to the thermometer. There you can see the wire or the cable. So this probe could be inserted. We could drill a hole and insert this into the brick, and it would give us a different reading at the top. Here we have a hole specially made for the probe. So if I insert that probe in there and I heat the tile up, either with the sun, but I'm going to use an artificial light, an halogen lamp, which is extremely hot to the touch, been going for quite a while. I'm going to bring it closer and just put it onto the brick and onto the tile to simulate the sun. Here you can see the light, part of the light. It's a double work light, really. So I'm just going to put this light onto the tile. Now, it will take a while. I'm going to stop now and continue later. After about 10 to 15 minutes, this tile is pretty hot now from the energy absorbed by the halogen lamp. And we can see the reading. The top one is the reading for the probe, which is inserted right there. So it's 42.4, and it was 19.2. So you can see slowly the tile would release its energy, and that is how passive solar works, where the sun is absorbed by bricks and tiles and other materials which are good heat sinks, and releases that heat slowly, especially during winter, which would save power and energy and making a building more energy efficient.